The first thing, of course, is we know that you've worked in the justice system for many years, and then you got into parliament. And when you were in parliament, the one thing that people remember is you walking out of a Moi function. Now that the former president is dying, has died, and we are looking back at the years, let's start with that. You walked out of a Moi function.
As I was entitled to.
So what is it that made you walk? What were you unhappy about on this particular day?
Like, you know, I walked, but you have not checked why I walked out. Yes.
Why you did know, you walk
yeah,
out?
Yeah, that's the reality. Why?
Kanu had this habit of disparaging the opposition. So Moi has come to Kirinyaga. And I've given him respect as head of state, therefore have gone to meet him as one of the leaders. And we go into the stadium where the Harambe was. They're giving chance to Kanu people to talk. And the Kanu local chairman starts insulting the opposition and even declaring that we are mad to think that Kenya can be led from Mudhaya. That was a direct insult to me and my party.
You were in the Democratic Party at that point.
Yes, and to my then leader, the then leader of my party, President, retired President Kibaki. So I just quietly tell President Moi, who was just one seat away from me, between me and him was Henry Kosgei, who was then the Minister for Education. So I tell him, you've got to give me a chance to defend my party. Then he asks me what I'm going to say if he gives me a chance. And I tell him, come on, I can't tell you what I'm going to say. I can only assure you I'll give you your due respect as head of state. So he said to Taona, but the body language told me he won't. So I just surveyed the area and got ready. I couldn't walk out on the, you know, the chairman talking or even the ministers. I want to walk
you
out
timed your
on
moment.
The sponsor. Because if he's unhappy with the way they're talking, he's in charge. He could have done something about it. Because the first thing I asked him is, how can you let your people talk like this? Then he said it's not him and he wouldn't do like that. So what I did was to survey the place and I saw the entrance that I'm going to use to exit. Because you can't walk behind him. It would look like an attack. So when he rose to speak, I took the side entrance, went in front of him and gave him the DP salute and walked out. If I can't talk, I can at least stage a silent protest, which is not against the law. I'm not disturbing the meeting. I'm just exiting as I'm entitled to, and I did.
It was quite impactful because people noticed it and people remember. Among the things that people remember as one way of protesting, of leaders protesting, was that. Martha Karua walking out, and you became the Iron Lady from that moment.
It had results because from then on, he never ignored the opposition in his gatherings. From Kirinyaga, he went to Meru. He allowed Kiraitu Murungi and the late Mweraria to address the meeting. He went to Kakamega. He allowed Wamunyinyi and others to address the meetings. From there on, that was the mark of the opposition.
So this was a catalyst? This was a catalyst for that to come through?
It did become, and I realized even a president doesn't like a walkout in a, you know, an embarrassment in a public meeting. So just to keep order in his meetings, he allowed the opposition to have its place.